Antoine Dupont. What a player. And to think the scrum half cupboard is pretty well stocked globally at the minute. Faf de Klerk, Aaron Smith. To rise above them is quite something. His ability to break down defences is like no other. And also to be a captain at the tender age of 24 tells us there's a lot more to come. There was a time when we asked which French team is going to turn up. And I think the fact we no longer ask that because we know their clinical team that are going to take their chances is largely down to the way he operates.
Well, I think in the last year or so, Ardy Sever has stepped up to become a global rugby icon, constantly one of the best players on the pitch and one of the most versatile. He carries like a number 8, he jackals like a number 7, he knocks about like a number 6. He is certainly one of the best players, if not the best player in the world.
Lukanyo Am is one of the new players on the Springbok scene. Not as famous as the likes of Dayalendi alongside him, or Andre Pollard, or Faf de Klerk, but I think we saw on the Lions tour, he's become world-class very, very quickly. And not only world-class as a typical Springbok, fierce, muscular, driving player, but he's also got skills and talent as well. And I think as far as the Springboks go, that's a really potent combination. And I think that up until the next World Cup, between now and then, and maybe after, he's going to be the best player in the world game.
Maro Itoje is pretty much the best player on the pitch. Every game he plays, and the bigger the game, the better he plays. I think his collision hardness is probably unsurpassed in the global game. And that's why he's the first name on the England team sheet and has been for years.
Over the last 2 years, Antoine Dupont has become such an important player for France and for Toulouse that it's almost impossible to imagine him not in those sides. He might not necessarily be the best scrum half in the world, but there are a few more influential rugby players. Absolutely unplayable with ball in hand. His kicking game has become exceptional. He's probably about as good a defensive nine as there is.
Michael Hooper, has he ever had a bad game? The Wallabies captain is a ferocious warrior at the breakdown, but also has silky skills in the backs. He could probably play in the centres and do a decent job. And you've got to look ahead to the future. He could well overtake Alan Wynne-Jones' cap record. Still so young and a long career ahead.
Aaron Smith, what a player. Not only does he have everything that you would expect a scrum half to have, the most exceptional pass and probably one of the best passes of the ball in the game, a fabulous box kick, running game, but his speed of thought, his ability to get the game going, to keep momentum flowing, the engine that he has as he's moving, speed of ball, everything. An exceptional rugby player when he was younger, now and on into the future.